Joining me now to discuss this is the wife of the imprisoned pastor. Naghmeh Abedini is here, and her lawyer, Jay Sekulow of the American Center for Justice and Law. Thank you both so much for being with us. Naghmeh, let me start with you here. Obviously, U.S. officials celebrating over the last few days, or at least lauding this deal that has been struck, this six-month deal on nuclear weapons with Iran. Meanwhile, you're heading into your second holiday season where your husband is away from you, imprisoned, separated. So how does this all make you feel right now?
It's painful. It came. It's a hard blow again as the holidays approach, Thanksgiving and Christmas. And for a lot of people, it's a happy time of the year. For us, it's a very painful time of the year. Saeed's missing from our family, but he's just not missing. He's in this horrible, horrible prison. This new prison. He's with murderers who are on death row, and we're worried about his health. He will not survive the 8 years if he's not. He doesn't get out of there immediately.
You have any sense of how he's doing? As you said, he has been moved to this prison that you think has much worse, much more dangerous conditions.
His family was able to see him not today, but the previous month, last week, and his health looked deteriorated. He looked skinnier, and even from Evan prison, and. They're very much worried about his health and his well-being. There's high prisoner-to-prisoner violence where he's at, has a high suicide rate and prisoner-to-prisoner violence and deaths. And his health, obviously, he hasn't been able to get the medication for his internal bleeding, and so he's not doing very well. And we're worried about him. And to think that we're here, the kids and I, I'm a single mom now, to get to sit together and celebrate Thanksgiving and Christmas knowing where he's at, it's very painful. My kids were crying this morning saying, God, don't let daddy die, bring him home. And it's painful to watch that.
That's gotta be so hard. President Obama, apparently, we're told, brought up your husband in a telephone conversation that he had with the Iranian president. Secretary Kerry, Secretary of State, has lobbied on your husband's behalf for his release. What more do you think the administration could do?
Well, they did, but what did the Iranian government do? They, on the day that they were chanting death to America, they took Saeed to a different prison. They didn't put him in a political ward. They put him in a ward where there's murders and rapists on death row, and they know there's a high violence rate there. So here they get a call and they get demands from Secretary of State and President Obama, and they do the exact opposite. And they show, it's not a confidence building step. Our government needs to, I expect them to speak out and say, we asked for his release and this is horrible what has happened. He's not gonna survive even one few months in that prison. This is Iran's continuous violation of human rights, and here's an American citizen who's being held there because he's a Christian, and he needs to be released immediately.
Jay, you're an attorney.
That could have been done here.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Let me say what could have been done here, and this is what has me troubled. And I sent a letter off to Senator Secretary of State Kerry on Friday. The fact of the matter is that before the release of billions of dollars of money that we've held back for sanctions. Before the release now of, quote, humanitarian aid directly to the Iranian government, we could have had as a precondition to this the release of Saeed Abedini and the other two Americans that are held as hostages in Iran right now. That should have been a precondition. When you've got the head of the National Security Council or the deputy making the statement that this was discussed at the peripheries, at the margins, and was brought up in the staff level but not any higher, is outrageous. We had the ultimate negotiating capability. The Iranian sanctions that the United States government has put on the Iranians have been significant enough that it brought the Iranians to the table. And we blinked. The United States blinked. And that's the tragedy in all this. Whatever happens with the agreement, whatever one views the merits of whether the agreement was the right move for us politically or not, or geopolitically, the fact of the matter is, it would have been, as one person told me today, a gimme, an easy one, for the Iranians to have released this pastor and the two other Americans. And as CNN's own Wolf Blitzer said today when questioning the spokesperson for the National Security Council, why is it that he is not released? Why was that not a precondition? Why wasn't Saeed Abedini and the others standing next to John Kerry when he announced this deal being struck. So we were across the table from the Iranians, and we did not bring home Americans. To me, that's a tragedy, and it's outrageous.
Naghmeh, I want to leave you with the last word here. If you could get a message to your husband, who is inside prison as we speak right now, what would it be?
Hang in there. We're, you know, I'm spending every waking moment working to get you out. The kids and I miss you, and we're proud of you for standing up for what you believe and your values, but hang in there, and we're going to get you out quickly. And, you know, I want to say this is a family torn apart. People usually see this, and it's another news story, but really it's really our family that's been torn apart and two little kids hurting.